Okay, hi Givers, this is Dennis from Give Asia. I'm here with me today, Del. Del is actually working in Singapore as a domestic helper. But then tragedy struck at home in Philippines where she was from. Okay, one son of hers is actually currently in the hospital due to motorcycle accident. You can see from the statement below there. And another son of hers is actually diagnosed with cancer, which is actually quite tragic. And being here in Singapore, she can't do anything much except that, you know, to try to raise funds to help them to pay off their medical bills. As those that knows about conditions in Philippines, that they don't have what we got here in Singapore, like MediSave, MediFunds. They have a very minimum subsidy that is, I think, only about 7,000 peso, which is how much in Sing dollars? 7,000 peso? A few hundred dollars?
Yes.
Okay. But let's hear a little bit from Del, you know, what actually happened. So, Del, you might share with me what happened to your son that got into the motorcycle accident?
My son is, the name is Chander.
Chander, okay. Okay.
That time, he go to the my sister. My sister got maybe got a party like that. And then after that party, but he want to go back home. That time.
I see. Okay. Yeah,
want to go back home. Then on the way go back home, on the road, there is no sign.
There's no signage.
Yeah, there is no sign because the bridge there the construction. So that's why maybe cannot see anything because you know in Philippines no have light, there's no street light.
Okay, no street light. Okay.
No street light. Then suddenly, that's why accident.
I see.
Yeah. Okay. By 2 p.m.
And how is he right now in the hospital over there? Is he slowly recovering?
Now she cannot remove the left side.
Oh, you cannot move the left side.
Yeah, left side.
Okay.
Then the doctor say must need physical therapy.
Physiotherapy, okay.
Physiotherapy.
Right.
So, physiotherapy is quite expensive in my place also.
I see, okay.
You find the, how to say, the for massage only.
Okay.
We pay 300 per session, 300 peso, 1 hour only.
I see.
1 hour.
Wow, okay, that's quite expensive. And your the other son suffering from cancer? How old is he?
Now he's 21.
21 years old?
Yes.
What kind of cancer is that?
They say brain tumor. Last year...
Oh, brain tumor?
Yes, brain tumor. This
wow.
Last year diagnosed, my sister say, before I had headache on me. Then I say you go to to eye optical clinic.
Yeah.
Because
okay.
Headache.
Right.
Then after that, you go to to optical. Then they say go to doctor hospital and take MRI. Then MRI come out the result.
Okay.
Then they say like that the brain tumor. Then me as a mother, I don't believe.
Of course.
I don't believe.
And he's also so young, 21 years old.
So I want second opinion.
Right.
Then I tell my boss I want to go back. I want to make sure you really have the brain tumor. So I bring to Manila.
Right.
Then they say, no, we cannot, if we do again the MRI, then they say the result is same. Then I don't believe also. So I bring to Baguio.
Okay.
Then not even that, I bring to Baguio. Then there, third opinion, then really come out like that.
Okay.
So the doctor say, please, decision now, because if you don't operate, the time, maybe your son, like 50% alive, 50%.
So, moving forward, what will be his treatment be? He got to go for surgery, and after that, remove the tumor.
No, sir. I decided not. No, they put. They operate, but cannot remove the tumor.
Okay.
Because the brain is in the root.
Oh.
Cannot touch one.
Oh. Okay. So how is he going to?
Now is on every month. Go check up the
okay.
But they operate, they put the tube here.
Okay.
But both then connect to the stomach.
Wow.
That's a permanent.
I see. Wow.
Mm. Okay. So every month got check up.
Okay.
Then now they say bring to MRI again.
Mm.
Dr. Igama say bring to MRI again.
Right.
MRI is quite expensive.
Expensive, yeah, I understand. Yeah.
MRI and ultrasound.
Mm.
Then there are two. How to? Only me working.
I understand. Understand.
That's
so
why.
I see. Okay. Give us. You've heard what Del has shared. You know, as a mother working in Singapore as a domestic domestic helper with a family back at home with two sons' condition like that, is actually taking a toll on her physically and mentally, as well as of course financially. I mean, if you can help, please be so kind to, you know, to donate whatever that you can help to her. And end of the day, if you can save a life, save her. Thank you so much, and you know, I wish you all the best. Hope that yourself will recover soon. Okay. Thanks.